How's it going, everybody? Welcome back into another video. Oh my god, we are here. Welcome to the final episode of this year's my top 100 favorite movies of all time. This is my top 10 favorite movies of all time. We're going 10 to 1 today. I am so excited to get into these. These are my 10 favorite movies of everything I've ever seen in my life. I've documented over 800 movies that I've seen. I know I've seen more than that. But these are the 10. These are the ones that just beat the rest. They are the cream of the crop. I absolutely love it. Before we get into that, you already know what I'm going to do. I'm plugging it right now. If you have not already, please consider subscribing. We are so close to 1,000 subs. We're getting to the end of the year. My goal was to hit it by the end of the year. So please, if you have not already, consider hitting the subscribe button. We will be doing this series again next year to see how the list has changed. And I'm just so happy that we finally made it. And I really appreciate you all watching. Please consider subscribing if you have not already. If you already have subscribed, please share with a friend. I want to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I've been on YouTube for over 7 years. I don't do this as a job, it is a hobby. This milestone would mean the absolute world to me. So please, if you have not already, consider subscribing. But today we are doing the top 10. These are my top 10 favorite movies of all time. The cream of the crop, the ones that rise above the rest. I am so excited. I'm going to do my 5 honorable mentions, which I hit in the last episode. Go check out the last episode, which is my top, my 20 through 11, but I'll do the 5 honorable mentions right now. At 15 was Before Sunset. 14 was The Empire Strikes Back. 13 was Avengers Infinity War. 12 was Nightcrawler, and 11 was Arrival. So those 5 just missed the top 10. But we have an incredible list of films here today to talk about. I am incredibly excited because they are my 10 favorite movies of all time. So I think without further ado, let's stop dilly-dallying. Let's get into it. So coming in at number 10 is Wildlife. Now you're probably asking, Jack, what the hell is Wildlife? It is this small indie film starring Carey Mulligan and Jake Gyllenhaal, directed by Paul Dano. It was his directorial debut that came out in 2018. This is one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had watching a movie. I didn't watch it in theaters. I watched it at home. It's on the Criterion Collection. Go buy it if you have not. It's an incredible movie. This is the most incredible look at a relationship, the deterioration of a relationship, and it really is just a character study of these two people who are raising a son, and we watch it through the eyes of the son. It is so incredible. It is heartbreaking. The performances are so, so good. The cinematography is beautiful. This is an incredible film. I love every single thing about it. Paul Dano's direction is to die for. Please, I implore you, please go watch this film. It is in-freaking-credible, and it comes in at number 10 on my list. Coming in at number 9 is Baby Driver. I freaking love this film. When I first saw it last year, I had to show everyone, showed everyone in my family. They all loved it. It is incredible. This is my favorite Edgar Wright movie. The editing, the direction around music is just to die for, and the direction in general from Edgar Wright is incredible. The performances are great. Not going to name certain names because they are icky people, and we do not like those people on this channel, but in the end, this is an incredible action-packed time. The best heist movie, well, not the best, but one of the best heist movies of all time, in my opinion. It is a lot of fun. It is action-packed. It is thrilling. It has a killer soundtrack. I absolutely love it. And it comes in at number 9 on my list. Coming in at number 8 is The Wolf of Wall Street. This is, I believe, Scorsese's best movie. This is also, I believe, the best performance from Leonardo DiCaprio. Such an interesting story. I love the look into Wall Street. I love the themes of greed and addiction and just how far you will go over the edge to be successful and wealthy is so interesting. The pacing of this movie is what I like to talk about because this is a 3-hour movie and it flies by so fast. It is incredible how fast this movie flies by. I already mentioned Leo. You got Margot Robbie, Jonah Hill, 2 other incredible performances. This film is an absolute banger. I love it. I ain't effing leaving. It's so much fun while also being serious because it is a serious subject. But my God, this is a blast. I love this movie so much. And it comes in at number 8 on my list. Coming in at number 7 is 12 Angry Men, a film I saw for the first time this year before I locked this list. This is probably the greatest screenplay I have ever seen put to film. I think the deterioration of an idea. So the idea is that this man is guilty of murder. He needs to be put to death. The deterioration of that idea to this other idea of no, there is doubt, he is innocent. That is written so incredibly well. The chain of events, the domino effect that happens in this film that starts with one person, then dominoes all the rest of them. It is absolutely incredible. The direction is to die for from Sidney Lumet. The, who am I trying to say? The performance from Henry Fonda is great. It's so good along with the rest of the cast. But Henry Fonda really is the standout. And this is just an incredible film. I think anyone that wants to be in filmmaking, wants to know about filmmaking, wants to do anything in this industry needs to watch this film because this is the textbook definition of what a good screenplay can be. Absolutely incredible, an incredible experience. I love it. And it comes in at number 7 on my list. You want to talk about another really good screenplay? Coming in number 6 is The Social Network. Fincher's best film. Incredible direction. Kick-ass performances from Jesse Eisenberg, Andrew Garfield, just to name those main two. Justin Timberlake is also really good in this as well, which is underrated because he just doesn't do a lot of acting. It's so interesting how they tell the story of Facebook through deposition hearings. That is so clever to me. I think the writing, like I said, is already very tight, very witty, incredibly impactful. And it's a shocking movie. It really is. The score from Reznor and Atticus Ross, Trent Reznor, Atticus Ross, that is a great score. And this is really a defining movie of the past decade. I think it is one of, if not the best movies of the decade, and it is a defining movie. And the fact that it did not win Best Picture, did not win Best, like it got snubbed on everything in the Oscars, is a crime. The King's Speech is fine, but The Social Network is a masterpiece. I digress. And it comes in at number 6 on my list. Coming in at number 5 is Django! Django Unchained, my favorite Quentin Tarantino movie. There's just something about the big bloody action sequences in this movie that just hit different. It's my favorite Western of all time. This is a movie that made me fall in love with the Western genre. Of course, I love The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly and other films like that. But this is the film that really got me involved. It is an incredible story. Awesome performances from Jamie Foxx, Christoph Waltz, Kerry Washington, and of course, our man Leonardo DiCaprio as Mr. Calvin Candy himself. This is a kick-ass movie. It just is. And that's what Tarantino does. He makes kick-ass movies. And this is an incredible one. Samuel L. Jackson also in this as well, who's very evil and villainous. I watched it for the first time last year. Jaw was on the floor. It's such an incredible movie. I love this one to death. My favorite Tarantino, and it comes in at number 5 on my list. Coming in at number 4 is Whiplash. Holy crap, this movie is a masterpiece. Some of the best cinematography I've ever seen. One of the greatest performances I've ever seen in J.K. Simmons as Fletcher. Miles Teller is also incredible in this movie. This is such an interesting look at the pursuit of perfection. You know, everyone wants to be perfect. And it's how far will you go to be the perfect, to be the icon, to be the star? That's what this film examines, and it does it so well. I my jaw was on the floor when I first watched this 2 years ago. Or no, last year. Last year was when I saw it for the first time. My jaw was on the floor. The direction from Damien Chazelle is just so masterful, and the final sequence is just incredible. It's just incredible. I mean, this movie is just a masterclass in directing, shot composition, cinematography, all of it. It's just so good. It is so good. I love this movie. It comes in number 4 on my list. Coming in at number 3, my favorite film from the master at work himself, Christopher Nolan, Inception. My top 3 you guys already know, but I freaking love Inception. It is the movie that really made me love movies. I had experiences before that with Infinity War and Endgame that really got me interested in movies, and I was like, I love this experience. I want to dive deeper. But Inception, I was like, holy crap, this is incredible. What is happening on my screen right now? In all the best ways. The action is awesome. The performances are great, but it's the story. It's the writing. I mean, where does Nolan come up with this stuff? It is just incredible. This is one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had. And I watched this at home on Netflix. And it was still one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had in my life watching a film. I've watched it 5 or 6 times now, and I've only saw it for the first time last year. It made me fall in love with film, the art of filmmaking. It made Christopher Nolan my favorite director of all time. And it comes in at number 3 on my list. Now, what's going to be at number 1 and what's going to be at number 2? Because you guys know what my top 2 are, but what's going to be where? I think I might surprise some people with this. Coming in at number 2 is Avengers Endgame. Not at number 1, number 2. But no doubt, it's still just an incredible feat of storytelling and closure. I talked about this in the last episode when I talked about Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2, that is the ultimate conclusion, and it is. It's the ultimate conclusion to a story. It is the ultimate closing of a book to a story that is never going to continue. Whereas Endgame is the incredible bookend to an era with more coming down the line. Not only did we get the incredible goodbyes for some of our characters, but we also got the passing of the torch to others. It set up the future extremely well. I love the time heist. I love going back to classic Marvel moments. I think the third act is like the greatest third act in movies. Sorry, you may hate me, but I think that's true. It's just fascinating to me how they were able to accomplish this. Kevin Feige, take a bow. He will get an honorary Oscar someday. I'm almost certain of it. Just an incredible feat of franchise building and a culmination of what had come before. I adore this movie. It has all the feels. It's just incredible. I am Iron Man. I love you 3000. It's phenomenal. And it comes in at number 2 on my list. Coming in at number 1. It's gotta be La La Land, right? It's gotta be La La Land. This is the greatest love story. And they don't even end up together in the end. This is the greatest screenplay that I've ever read and seen on screen. Damien Chazelle directs his masterpiece. This is the film he had always wanted to make. He made Whiplash so that he could make this film exactly the way he wanted to. And rightfully so. It is a project of passion. It is a project about dreamers and people that are going to do whatever it takes to accomplish their dreams. Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone are incredible in this movie. Emma Stone won an Oscar. It is very deserving. The music is incredible. This is one of the best movie soundtracks of all time. Justin Hurwitz is a master at work. And it's just my favorite movie. It's rewatchable. It resounds. It hits home. It's so well done. I mean, I could gush about this for hours, and I'm working on a video essay about it. I've been working on it for about a year now, but I'm still working on a video essay about this movie, which I hope to share with you guys sometime in the future. But I love this movie, safe to say. It's absolutely incredible. And it is my favorite movie of all time. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That is my top 10 favorite movies of all time. I'll round them out real quick for you guys again. Coming in at 10 is Wildlife. 9 is Baby Driver. 8 is The Wolf of Wall Street. 7 is 12 Angry Men. 6 is The Social Network. 5 is Django Unchained. 4 is Whiplash. 3 is Inception. 2 is Avengers Endgame. And 1 is La La Land. Go down below in the comments. Let me know what was your favorite movie that I talked about today. And also let me know what is your favorite movie of all time. I want to thank you all so much for taking the time to watch this series. It's taken a lot of time. We've gotten through it. It's 11 episodes long. Go back to the playlist. There's a playlist of every episode in order. Go back to the playlist and go watch all the episodes if you've not already. Subscribe if you've not already. It means the absolute world. Let's get 2,000 subscribers by the end of the year. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a rest of your day, and we'll see you in the next video.